to do a video of testing the new Evolution hovercraft here. It's very windy today. It's going to be raining and storming here before too long. So it's a pretty good test of kind of odd conditions on the river. It looks like the river is actually flowing backwards from the wind. But I'm going to try to do a quick little demo, show you how the machine handles, show you how the new angle rudders we have induce a roll, so you don't have to lean quite like you did on the previous generation machines. And then the plowing characteristics, which I'm really proud of on this machine. It has pretty much no plow. You just let off the gas and you slow down just like you would in a boat. So without further ado, let's see if we can get a good video here. My GoPro is broken right now, so I'm going to go try to take this with my phone. It might not be the best because I have to wedge my phone in my life jacket, so it's not exactly the ideal position. We'll give it a shot.
While we're getting ready, I should address the raw honeycomb composite you see here. This is our production prototype machine, and it has no paint or gel coat. Rest assured, the final version will be a lot prettier. First off, I'm going to give the experienced hovercraft pilots who are watching a little anxiety. I'm going to head upstream with a strong tailwind, and at about 30 miles per hour, I'm going to suddenly cut the lift to idle. In a lot of hovercraft, this would be the perfect setup for a pretty hard plow-in. Keep your eye on the surroundings because the GPS-driven speedometer lags behind a bit when your speed changes suddenly. For those watching this video, the experienced pilots are probably really impressed, while those new to hovercraft are shrugging their shoulders and asking themselves what they missed. What we call a plow-in is when a hovercraft stops riding on a cushion of air and the hull makes contact with the water. Many hovercraft, particularly older designs, have plow characteristics that can vary from unpleasant to dangerously violent, in some cases resulting in the occupants going for an unexpected swim. The combination you just saw of traveling at high speed with a strong tailwind and against the river current is generally one of the worst-case scenarios for a hard plow-in. Obviously, this is virtually non-existent in the Evolution. The hull shape is engineered in such a way that it prevents the sudden deceleration necessary for a hard plow-in. I'll do it again later in the video so you can get a second look. Now let's take a look at the rudders. You may have noticed that they're at different angles, not parallel like most other hovercraft. The Evolution rudders are designed to cause a roll or banking force while in a turn. This significantly reduces the amount of leaning required by the pilot and passengers. I'm really pleased with how this worked out. Since you don't have to move around as much, flying the Evo is both easier and more enjoyable than other four-passenger hovercraft. It feels quite nimble. A strong wind is coming straight up the river, so that last turn was out of a tailwind and into a headwind. Once we build up some speed, we'll do another plow test to see if it's any different in this direction. Just as before, we got a nice smooth stop, which is exactly what we want. Now we'll get over hump into that strong headwind. What we call getting over hump in the hovercraft world is essentially climbing over the bow wave generated when starting from a dead stop on water. It took a little longer because of the strong headwind, but to be fair, this isn't a good test without a whole lot more payload on board. With just one person inside, the hump phenomenon is almost non-existent. The wind noise totally changes as they switch directions. At this point, it's time to head back to the ramp. I've been out for over an hour, it's starting to sprinkle, and I know there's some hard rain arriving soon. After spending some time with this new design, I'm really happy with the performance. Even though the Evolution is slightly larger than our previous generation Coastal Pro 2, it feels like you're flying a much smaller machine. Anyone who has seen it has commented on how quiet and unobtrusive it is. There are obviously many improvements that have been made, only a few of which have been mentioned in this video. But if I had to pick one single feature that I'm most proud of, it's the hull construction. I've spent most of my life flying hovercraft, more makes and models than I can remember from all over the globe. And this hull is, without a doubt, the strongest and most durable of any hovercraft I've seen. The fact that Evolution manages to do that while also offering a significant weight reduction truly is, well, an evolution.
Might be a bit stronger than necessary.